It's John and Rachel. It's your Jagoff Late Night. We are at 5000 McKnight Road and where you should be almost every Friday. Actually, not next Friday because we're recording on Wednesday. So if you're looking for a cocktail hour next Wednesday, come
this is the next place.
Wednesday. This there you is go. The place to be. You're listening to your Jagoff Late Night either on the radio, on your podcast feed, or watching it on YouTube. We would appreciate it if you subscribe to it everywhere or just listen to it on the radio every Friday.
And while you're committing to things, make sure that you are reading our blogs every day, 7-ish, right? Sometimes John sleeps in.
Yeah.
But most of the time, you get your take on Pittsburgh drivers, on Pittsburgh parkers, on Pittsburgh road rage, all that good stuff. This week on the blog, though, we had some really positive things. The first thing,
right. The Palomalas were in town and they're getting ready to kick off the Resilience Bowl, which is a flag football game. It is Coach Cower versus Coach Tomlin, including some names that we already heard. But Ben Roethlisberger is one of them.
Yeah.
And so it's super cool.
It's but it's a be flag football. It's not
that's
real.
What I say. Yeah, flag
Did
football.
Did you say flag?
Yep.
All right.
7-on-7. Anyways, we had a cool thing because we got to interview them. So go watch the video.
And isn't today Palomalu's birthday?
It
Thank
is
you,
today.
Dan. Cashado.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
yes,
so
is.
Happy birthday to the one and only Troy Polamalu. Also, the second blog that we have to talk about is Spectrum Fudge. You know those days where you put tons and tons of time into something that you want to be really good and you're like, wow, this didn't go over so well. Well, that's the opposite of what happened. We were like, we need to announce and make a splash about the fact that we have a fudge. It is black and yellow. Of course, it's a Yinzer fudge from Spectrum Fudge. So it's banana and chocolate. And so we did a little video that everybody loved because you stole the show at the end.
Well,
do the face, John. He was mad.
Fudge.
So anyway, check out our fudge. It's on our store, but you can also get it at Spectrum Fudge. They will also be at the Yinzer Fest that's coming up next Thursday.
Right. And Bikes on a Car was one of our blog posts. I was driving up. As a matter of fact, we were just talking about the Seneca Valley area. And there was a car being passed up by a tractor trailer, which is crazy. The tractor trailer is on the right hand side. The car is in the passengers or the passing side.
Mm-hmm.
And he's carrying three bikes.
Mm-hmm.
If you're carrying three bikes, you should not be in the fast lane. You Jagoff.
There you go. I like how you say it.
Yeah.
You do that very well,
right.
Very eloquently.
So, three bikes? Are you kidding me?
We have some term of endearment Jagoffs here tonight. We're super excited to chat with. First and foremost, we are getting some spirits. We're not just getting spirits. We're getting sweets
Ooh.
As well.
Not those kinds.
Spirits and sweets. Spirits, thankfully, is from Christian Kale, and it's Lucky Sign Spirits. We're mm-hmm. super stoked to talk to him, as well as JJ, who's going to give us all the dish on distillery dues. How's that? Say
that
three times fast.
And we have something that relates to Q92.9 because WQED is here. Gina, our friend Gina, is here to talk about a special project that they're working on. And then we have two people talking about Strawberry Jell-O Pretzel Salad.
Because it's happening here in the North Hills on Sunday. We'll let you hear from them, but two different versions, and we get to taste test them. Plus, the one, the only, Liz Berlin is here performing as our musician. First up, though, you get to see a little Mitch Minute with Mitch Dugan. Thanks for joining us on YaJagoff Late Night.
I was born and raised in Pittsburgh, and it's got everything anybody could want. There's a lot of things in Pittsburgh I like to do. Pittsburgh has a lot to offer, I think, being born and raised here. The parks are one of them, and there's lots of places to hike in and around Pittsburgh. I started hiking, I think, during COVID, like most people, getting out of the house because, you know, cabin fever, that kind of thing. I mean, Pittsburgh's great, right? You have, you know, Shenley Park, Frick Park. You can go out to McConnell's Mill, Raccoon State Park. I'm not prepared to randomly hike. No. It's all, you know, I'm prepared to work. That's all I do. So if I'm going to go hiking or biking or something, it's definitely I have to do it around my work schedule. I always take my cell phone with me wherever I go. I'm checking my emails more than everybody likes. Well, it depends on the weather, right? So, you know, I think it's heavily dependent on the weather and how you dress. So that would be most important. Socks and shoes. Tennis shoes, if it's a short hike, or I have some hiking shoes, which are, you know, fancy tennis shoes, right? Right. And, you know, you just get download an app on your phone in case you get lost, you know where you're going. It's a good thing to have. And if it's a hot summer day, then you definitely want to have bug spray. You know, if you're worried about ticks, probably long sleeves and a bottle of water bring with you if it's a hot day. Does this get edited? Do you guys edit these?
Yes, that's exactly the
I listen to YaJagoff's podcast and you should too.
I would say probably the softest side of me is my mother. Very empathetic, you know. No one to mess with, though, but she was very empathetic.
It's Rachel and John.
We are at the Operations Center of People's Gas for this episode of People.
Behind People.
I feel like we're taking over. You're seeing more women in manager positions and supervisors, and they know what they're doing.
Women with Energy is a great ERG. We do not play. We are very energetic. We get the job done.
If my younger self could see me doing these things now, I wouldn't believe it. To be a steam fitter, you need to be a problem solver. You can do instrumentation, hydronics, chillers, rigging, HVAC. I have this wonderful opportunity to grow my career.
It's not what you are that makes you a steam fitter. It's who you are. Over 100 years, and we're just getting started.
Mancini's Bakery, 97 years in business and still getting better. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Instagram. That's where you will see various Pittsburgh personalities like Gretchen McKay, Super Bowl MVP Santonio Holmes, KDKA's own Mary Hours, and WPXI's Jenna Harner, learning how to make the famous Italian twist bread. Follow Mancini Bakery on Instagram and Facebook, and remember to ask for Mancini's.
It's John and Rachel, your Jagoff Late Night. And once again, you can look behind us there. There's people that gather. You can gather here every Friday, except for next Friday because we're recording on Wednesday. If you're looking for a place to hang out next Wednesday evening, come do it.
If you're looking for a place to hang out, the next two guests are going to tell you where it is.
That's exactly right, because we're talking spirits.
Yes, and you're rolling something out. But before we do that, typical John and Rachel, we actually had Christian here as a guest of someone else before. And then he just sort of teased us and was like, me and my partner and JJ, we're going to come bring you some spirits. We were like, in, when are you coming? So it literally went down like that. So exactly. Pittsburgh, right? So welcome. Tell us who you're with and introduce JJ and why he's such a big deal. He is more than Pittsburgh famous.
Oh, he is more than Pittsburgh famous. So I'm Christian with Lucky Sun Spirits, and we are now introducing a new brand called Honest Hillbilly, which Honest Hillbilly really came about because of JJ. So JJ is our new head distiller as of a couple months ago, and he's been
working on... Cue the confetti.
On...
We forgot.
Yeah, seriously.
I'm sorry.
I'll have it out in the vehicle for
you. There you go.
Lucky Sun Spirits, we've been around for about 3.5 years. Honest Hillbilly, we're just about to release our first bottle. We're just waiting for label approval. Let's just give it to JJ.
Yeah. He's
really okay. So
JJ, first of all, are you going to embarrass us and say you're one of those people that paid attention in chemistry class and now you're benefiting from that? Because I'm going to get mad.
I would say that I paid attention in backwoods chemistry class.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I'm on the Moonshiner Show on Discovery Channel.
Okay.
So I'm working with Mark and Digger down in the woods of Tennessee. Mm-hmm. And we actually filmed an episode up here in Pittsburgh for last season.
Okay.
And they showcased the Hill District and they did like a whole storyline about the speakeasies.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
The underground liquor market.
Yes, I remember.
So we did that up here. And, you know, I guess in the same vein of that, me and Christian hooked up through some internet back channels and... You know, as it moonshiners will do.
It wasn't like any.
Okay.
Nothing too crazy, but we hooked up, and I came on as the head distiller. And you know what we really wanted to do was bring pre-prohibition style spirits to the forefront.
And what does that mean?
Yeah, right. Good question, Rachel.
So post-prohibition, Rachel. Yeah.
Post-prohibition, what they were doing with moonshine in the backwoods was that they were sugaring in a lot of their mashes. And what sugaring in is they would add sugar so they could bump the alcohol yield of what they were making. But pre-prohibition, they were using what came out of the field, whether it's surplus grain, surplus fruit. And it was, I don't want to say unsullied, but it didn't have that bump in sugar. So you were getting whatever yield you were getting
out of
excess agriculture.
Okay.
So with Honest Hillbilly.
A more natural way of doing it.
I was just going to say,
exactly.
And healthy.
So
come on.
No post distillation flavoring. Everything comes from the ingredients that go into the mash and get run through the still.
Got it.
So that was our aim with Honest Hillbilly, and I think we definitely hit that mark right on the head.
All
right.
Okay. All right. So you're sampling glasses already. Should I plan on going
lemon
chill?
No.
This is the Honest Hillbilly then that we're about to try.
No.
This.
That is Lucky Sun Spirits Limoncello.
Oh, the Limoncello. Because
John loves Limoncello. Limoncello. How about another thing,
it's
Tracy,
better
when John loves something?
Ice cold, but it is what it is.
I smell it now.
Yeah.
It is our absolute bestseller.
It is.
Okay. Well, yeah, I can see why.
Yeah. Yep. I was like, whoa, what was that reaction?
Trip him on the way out so he drops the bottle, but
don't
fantastic. Break the bottle.
That's fantastic.
Thank you.
So that is not something you're rolling out. You have that all the time. Because we talked about this when you were here.
The Lucky Sun Spirits, all of these spirits have been out for a while now. Mm-hmm. So we'll give you a couple samples of these, and then we'll give you a couple samples of what's coming for the Honest Hillbilly. And you can kind of see the difference. So this is really more of like what you'd consider the post-prohibition style.
Okay.
Now, it's not quite the same as other moonshines. This isn't really moonshine. These are real actual spirits. We try to make the Lucky Sun Spirits line of spirits really elegant spirits, you know, really great flavors.
Okay.
Just, it is what it should taste like.
Okay.
Whereas Honest Hillbilly, really, again, we don't use the moonshine word. We don't use the M word.
Are you okay with that?
Moonshiner
JJ?
Joe.
Yeah, yeah, seriously. I mean,
but at the end of the day, like, even in what I do, like, on the show or, you know, elsewhere, like, I think that there's a place to elevate moonshine to something different than just, you know, sweetness in a jar.
Gotcha. I gotcha. Right? That's what you used to call me in high school. All right. So where does everybody find your spirits?
We're in Gibsonia, 50 Oak Road. 50 Oak Road, Gibsonia, PA.
Right. Website?
Yep. LuckySignSpirits.com.
JJ's like, I got it.
Yeah, you got it.
And you can follow us on Instagram at Lucky Sign Spirits. You can follow me on Instagram at High and Angry. Or, you know.
Yeah.
You can find me.
You have so many handles.
You can find me in. You can find me in the back.
You can't find this guy. He has a different handle for every different day. All right.
Wait. I just have one quick question. Why Pittsburgh? Why did you end up coming here then? After all the things that you did.
Well, I'm a graduate of Pitt, but I was in the Army for a number of years, and then I got out of the Army, and my wife is from here, so
nice.
She said,
it made sense.
As many times as she said, "Oh, we're not moving back." Yeah, we moved back.
Nice.
I love it.
All right,
you
the
guys.
The other sample you guys have is our cinnamon bourbon. It's the adult version of Fireball.
Okay. All right.
You were going to say
the elevated version.
All right. So we did the website, and we have a question of the day. All right? Question of the day.
It's smoother than Fireball.
It's karaoke. What is your go-to karaoke song, and can we get you guys to sing it?
It doesn't have to be a joint effort, but Liz Berlin is in the room, and I have a feeling she may critique... Like,
do it.
Are you karaoke?
Just break
people?
Out into song.
Are you karaoke people?
Frank
JJ?
Sinatra.
What's
your best one?
New
What's your
York.
Go-to? My way.
My way. Fly Me to the Moon is really my favorite.
Okay.
So.
All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Get in on that.
I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back these feelings for long.
We know your music handle. It's going to be Music Matt. Music Moonshine Matt.
I totally took you for New Kids on the Block.
All right. That was an audition.
All right. Do you guys have a junk drawer item for us? What do we hear?
I do.
Oh, look.
He's not even selling
them. And for those listening to the audio only, he has eclipse glasses.
Yeah, the eclipse glasses.
Yes.
I think I'm good for, I don't need them for 20 years. So.
Right.
Yeah, there you go.
Right.
Least.
So you,
JJ, so what are you giving us? Rarely, this?
I very rarely buy scratch-offs. But every time I do win, I put it in the drawer, and I'm like, I'll cash this in later.
And maybe it's
And
worth
then
something.
I don't even know if I'll ever cash. This one's worth $10, but I don't even know if I'll ever cash
You're
it
cashing
in.
You're cashing it in. You jag off later.
Maybe even on the way
so
home.
So much money, he doesn't even need it.
Someone's going to come raid our junk drawer and try to find that thing.
That is so funny. You guys, one more time, the website.
www.luckysignspirits.com.
You guys, check it out.
Well,
it's a Pittsburgh
done.
Thing, and it was done really well. All right, next up, we're going to talk a little strawberry jello pretzel salad with the one and only Jen from Isley. Stay with us, you jag off late night.
I've been thinking that Rohrich Automotive needs a new jingle.
Rohrich Automotive!
Automotive got the best cars around Pittsburgh.
Driving a Rohrich, I bought it at Rohrich. Picked up my new car at Rohrich Automotive.
I got friends at Rohrich Automotive, where the staff is nice and the dealership's loaded with brand new cars. And you can drive real far.
Welcome to Fernandez. Can I take your order?
You need a tap in?
No, we don't use this. We know how to yell the sandwich to put in the cook. Here we go.
Let's dig in.
It's John and Rachel. We love to dig into iconic Pittsburgh places like Permanis. So we brought our friends from People's Gas.
Please call at least 3 business days before you dig.
It doesn't matter if it's a big project or something small like a mailbox. Always call before you dig.
I called. We can dig in.
So please call 811. 3 business days before excavating so you don't have to call 911.
Monica, this week's Jeet Jet, we're hanging at Valley Dairy in Latrobe, and I got Joe, the training director for Valley Dairy. The infamous banana split.
Yes.
What's going on with that?
The banana split, it was born in Latrobe.
Okay.
By David Strickler, and I'm going to show you how to make one.
All right, well, let's do this.
Plato of each.
Nice.
And then chocolate, the best on the chocolate.
And again, that's a generous amount.
Yes, no skimping here. And I'm going to let you decorate that one.
Okay. So strawberry on the strawberry.
Strawberry on the strawberry, pineapple on the vanilla, and chocolate on the chocolate.
It's John and Rachel, YaJagoff Late Night, so we appreciate the spirits. Now the spirit of strawberry Jell-O pretzel salad, which is the Yinzer spirit. Jen Gregg from Isley's. How are you?
I'm doing well, guys. How are you?
We've had Jen on so many times. And I said, this is how I describe her. She's like, what are my talking points? I'm like, we'll talk about it when you get there.
Yeah.
It's all good. But we're really excited because we're used to talking to you, obviously, Isley's. We've talked to you about chipped ham. We've talked to you. We've done other things together.
Ice cream.
In the dead of winter that wasn't winter. It was spring, I think, and it was just snowing. Right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
But now you are using your famous ice cream and you are participating with us at our third now annual strawberry Jell-O pretzel salad standoff right here at the Block Northway. How excited are you?
So excited.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're going to be doing a milkshake.
Oh, my God.
We're going to be doing a strawberry Jell-O pretzel salad milkshake with our Isley's vanilla ice cream.
Okay.
And we're going to add some Jell-O powder, some salt.
Okay.
To get that pretzel flavor in there. Then we're going to top it all off with a little bit of whipped cream and a pretzel and some pretzel topping. We're including it all. We're getting it all in there.
Jen, how did we come up with this concoction? Were there seven chefs up at the Isley's confectionery going through this? Was it you at home making your family taste these until they tasted good?
Yeah,
how did this go?
We had the whole team trying it.
Okay.
We had everyone in the building. Okay, we need to add a little bit more salt. Okay, so take out the pretzel in it, put the pretzel on top, add the salt.
Wow.
So we had lots and lots of notes.
I love this. And what I love the most is that these purveyors, they're actually giving their recipes to people. So they're not just saying like, hey, I'm bringing it.
Yeah.
And the beauty is it won't taste this good if you don't use Isley's ice cream.
Absolutely.
Fair?
It never could. So that's super cool. So do we get to taste at this point?
I mean, look at it.
Actually, what we'll do
look
is...
Look at that.
So you're going to, for those on the radio, she's putting the Ready Whip on it. We'll taste it while you tell us a little bit of the history of Isley's and how you guys keep recreating these ice creams. Oh, look.
Yeah,
okay, she's sprinkling the pretzels on.
We got to sprinkle a little bit of the pretzels on.
All right.
Here we go.
Oh, and a little pretzel topper.
There you go.
All right, there we go. There's Rachel's.
Oh, thanks, John.
All right, so...
Super
as we eat this, because we have to, you know, we have to keep our candy with our mouths open.
Yeah.
So go ahead and tell us a little bit about Isley's and the history here in Pittsburgh.
Yeah. So Isley's started in Ohio in 1904. And, you know, they were really known back then for their dairies. And they were really known for milk, ice cream, all things dairy. It wasn't until we were out in Pittsburgh that chipped ham really came to be an Isley's staple. So, you know, we're really bringing it back to the roots with Isley's ice cream. And so we won't have it on Sunday, but we do have a brand new flavor that we launched this spring, Isley's chocolate chip. And we actually make it the Isley's way, the old-fashioned Isley's way, with chocolate jimmies or chocolate sprinkles. So,
our Mary Brito's tried it. Remember, we did the video? It was phenomenal. That is fantastic. Listen, I have to give a crunchy shout-out because the other strawberry pretzel confectioner from Kemi's Kitchen, we were on Talk Pittsburgh, and she said, the one thing I want to try is the milkshake. Wait till she tries this.
Oh, my gosh,
It is phenomenal.
Wow, it is.
I wouldn't be able to choose.
I think this needs to be the new YaJagoff ice cream flavor.
Jen, he just threw that out there.
I like that.
All right, so Jen, well, if people want to find your ice cream flavors, where they can buy them, and the Chip Tam, where do they go?
So any local grocery store, Giant Eagle, Coon, Shop and Save, you know, the ice cream will be in the frozen section, and the Chip Tam in the deli. And, you know, you can always, for our barbecue sauce, and we also have coffee. We have Isley's Boulevard Coffee.
Those items.
You can purchase on our website, isleys.com, and if you're looking for it, we also have a find page if you're looking for the ice cream or the Chip Tam.
Jen, if you are to win, which I love you so much, Augusta, but this really stands a good chance, who is your charity? Who are you bringing along with you?
Yeah, so we're partnering with First Tee of Pittsburgh. They're over at Shenley Park. They have the newly refurbished Arnold Palmer Learning Center. So yeah, we're really looking forward to partnering with them, and you know, we hope they win. Yeah.
And so if somebody doesn't know what we're talking about, every one of these purveyors is pairing up with a different charity, and we have the Berg Bus, and we have Truro Family Chiropractic, who are donating money. And that charity gets the money from Taste Buds. It's just people coming and tasting.
If you're listening to the podcast and next week, not the Friday night that we're doing it, then you need to go back and see who actually won. There'd be some videos. So Jen Gregg from Isley's
is committing to coming on every Friday with these milkshakes.
Bringing everybody milkshakes. And all right, so first of all, do you have a junk drawer?
No, because she came late. So her
junk
drawer.
It's these.
Yeah, wait. We'll do Ready Whip Bong.
Look how resourceful Jen is.
It's Ready Whip Bong.
I love it. Yeah. We'll do whippets. It's all good. So, Jen, I know that you're shy. I know that you always want talking points, but we have to put you on the spot because in May, we are partnering with the city paper, and we are doing something called Karaoke Cabaret at the one and only Mr. Smalls. And so we're super stoked. And what would your karaoke go-to song be? You had a couple drinks.
You had your spirits with Christian. You know your secret song.
What are you going to get up and sing?
Oh,
and if you don't want to sing it, I will. Go ahead. You tell
me. All right. Backstreet Boys.
Backstreet's back.
We're back.
All right.
There we go. That's the one.
Jen Gregg, thank you so much for joining us. We can't wait to see you on Sunday. Check out Isley's
and
we're excited.
Rachel's like the designated singer, like a batter in baseball.
No one even asks. I just do it.
It's your Jagoff late night.
PittsburghUsedCars.com. With hundreds of used cars across 8 dealerships throughout the city, we provide the greater Pittsburgh area with a premium used car buying experience. Looking for unbeatable pricing on some of the best used cars in Pittsburgh? Visit Pittsburgh Used Cars Clearance Zone today. We're providing out-the-door pricing on all of our clearance zone inventory. PittsburghUsedCars.com.
People used to celebrate hard work, the spirit of the underdog. You don't hear too much about those things anymore. The world needs more problem solvers. People who know results matter. Folks with brains and elbow grease. Our work runs through just about every office building in the city like a network of veins. It's not what you are that makes you a steam fitter. It's who you are.
We are here with Gina Groen from the Northside Chamber of Commerce. So guess where we are?
The Northside.
Yes. So first, Gina, tell us a little bit, if you will, about the Chamber. And then we're going to catch some sights of this neighborhood.
So the Northside Chamber of Commerce has been around since 1897. And so we support the Northside business community. So there are about 400 businesses that are members of the Chamber. And we promote, connect, and support them.
Oh. So, John and Rachel, I don't know what the difference between this is and this. I guess I got this, then I got that. Where is Thumpkin? Anyways, it is Gina from WQED back on our Jagoff Late Night. Welcome back.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Well, she has not been on. Let's just make that point clear.
No. I was at the parade.
You were here.
You're right.
I came here to observe and drink.
But you were not here for the spirits, so you need to get on those spirits.
I got to go back. They got little tiny, like.
Yes. Limoncello.
Yeah, but I might use one of the red Solo cups. Yes.
We won't judge you, Gina.
That kind of week, huh? There you go.
So, Gina, we've actually been talking to you about what would your topic be? WQED is like the epitome of Pittsburgh. It is the media, right? Everybody knows WQED, and it's just so much to really absorb. We could talk about so many different things, but today we get to talk a little bit of education because that is your bucket, right?
That is my bucket.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So tell us what you're kind of here to chat with us about, because it's a great topic that most people need to listen in on.
Well, thanks. So just a little context that really what WQED is trying to do is make sure that we are engaged in the community, not just like through our media, but actually using our media as catalysts to make sure we're really connecting with people and creating relationships within the community, listening to what the community needs and wants, and then using that information to create content, to create experiences that actually help neighborhoods grow and thrive. Yeah. So part of that, and a big part of that falls into the education space, which is where I live. Mm-hmm. And we do that through all kinds of different outreach events. I was just in Canonsburg today at a World of Work event where we had a whole bunch of people talking about their careers and the skills that it takes to connect to those careers for young children. So doing a lot more of that. Okay. And one of the new projects that we received funding from the Marcus Presidio Foundation to do, Charitable Trust Foundation, is a storyboarding contest. And so we also have a film academy that teaches students middle school to high school how to create content.
Amazing content, yeah.
Yeah, really good content. You would not guess it's from students, award-winning. We've been accepted into several film festivals. So we're really excited about that. But this opportunity takes what the Film Academy is doing and helps to kind of age it down a little bit and engage kids that are really young. So we've created a contest in for children in kindergarten, first, second, and third grade. What we're asking those students to do is create storyboards, which is the beginning of any good content mm-hmm. that you wanted to create. Mm-hmm. So we're asking kids to create a 5-7 panel storyboard that talks about bullying prevention. We want to really give young children
such a hot topic, and not just hot topic, but an important topic.
Yeah, and we want to make sure we're giving young children and their parents the tools and resources they need to help, like, prevent some of this stuff from happening whenever they come into like those situations.
And brilliant.
So the contest kicks off on May 1st, but right now we are offering 10 schools the opportunity for us to go into a classroom and have our Film Academy teaching artists teach their students how to storyboard.
How do they do that, North Hills? How does that happen?
So you go onto our website and there's a registration form. You just click it and you sign up. The beauty of it is that you don't have to have that workshop to participate.
Okay, oh, gotcha, okay. Yeah.
So we're offering off 10 of those, but those will be recorded by the Film Academy students, those workshops, and then those workshops and lessons will be placed on our website with all of the other resources and materials that students and families would need to enter
the
contest.
Toolkit.
Yeah, that's amazing, right?
Wow.
So this is cool because we're, as Rachel will typically say, we're teaching them in a sneaky way. We're letting them do things, make things
on. We're tricking them into learning. Yeah.
And so I like that. But my question would be is it harder, let's say you get a first, second, third grader, or even fourth grader at this point, they already kind of know how to work an iPhone maybe, you know, or make some videos. So is it retraining them or is it really training them? Because some of them seem to be so technically capable at this point.
Yeah. And so it's actually taking and building on what they know.
Okay.
And helping them transfer those skills to different interviewing skills, audio skills, like using miking people, those kinds of things, using a handheld camera and not just your phone. And so introducing them into different ways to create media and content.
Oh, wow.
That is really smart. Yeah. Wow. How did you guys come up with this? Was this something that you sort of storyboarded, thinking like, how did you choose the topic and how did you choose the manner in which?
Yeah. So
you almost said good question. I saw it. It didn't come out, but I saw it. It was coming.
So for over 15 years, we have run the WQED's Writers Contest. Mm-hmm. Where we ask kids to submit stories. And this, the last 3 years, it's been focused on careers. So it's Write My Future.
Sure.
And so that has been super successful for us, and kids really loved it. And so we thought, kind of building on that model, we decided to go the storyboard route. And kids want to create content. They want to create media, not just print media, right? So right. Have the kids storyboard, create their spots, their PSAs, and then make sure those winners come to the studio and are part of the creation that the Film Academy students make to bring to life.
Right.
The storyboarding thing is interesting because all of us just like to go make videos.
Right.
Right. And I mean, I don't think we've ever storyboarded anything, right? You know, so the fact is you're teaching them to slow the process down, think it through, and decide.
We did when we did our Fudge commercial. I was like, John, let's get you mad outside. that's one storyboard, you know.
But I think it's interesting that we're teaching them to slow the process down and think it out a little better, right?
That's right. Yeah.
Step by
step.
It's like that critical thing, like really giving kids the critical thinking skills that they need as they get older. As they decide kind of what they want to do, how they want to do it. It's really just about exposing kids to all different kinds of opportunities and having them think about. Them think about, what am I good at? What do I really like to do? And taking those skills and connecting them to something that they can be successful in the future.
You're so good at this, Gina. I'm so glad.
And
that
the cool thing is WQED is a learning institution. I know we think of it as a TV channel or a radio channel, but it is a learning institution based here in Pittsburgh with so many educational roots. Right?
Lifelong learning. Everything that happens, I feel like, on our airwaves, in our building, on, you know, classic FM, with Voice of the Arts, it's all lifelong.
We were
learning.
On Classic FM.
Right in a break.
We said YaJagoff on Classic FM. And,
You had Anna Singer saying YaJagoff.
Right. And one of our followers said, we were listening. We heard
you. That was crazy.
Like, what?
Yeah.
Look at that crossover in audience.
I'm telling you, see? Boom.
Gina, we love when you come here, and we appreciate, obviously, the work that you're doing for so many different generations. Where can everybody find out more specifically about this particular journey?
So if you go to WQED.org/education/storyboarding, you can find it there. Or the easiest way, honestly, sometimes is to just Google WQED storyboarding contest, and it'll pop up and you can get right
to
it.
And it starts May 1st, you said?
So all of the materials and resources will be available May 1st. Right now, the form is open for educators to sign up.
Awesome.
And so that's open right now. May 1st, all of the resources, materials will be available for everybody.
Okay.
And let me make sure I get all of my dates right. So I've got my little cheat sheet on my phone here. Sorry.
Yes.
It's because my face ID.
She's trying to get out of the karaoke part.
No, she's not. She has no problem singing. She wants me to sing, I think. I think that's what's happening.
I would love a duet. So the contest launches on May 1st. Students are submitting their creative storyboards with kindness themes between May 1st and June 30th.
Mm-hmm.
June 30th, it's the deadline for them to submit. And then the July 9th through 11th will be the judging.
Okay.
So we'll have a panel of esteemed judges. Don't be surprised if you get a phone call or an invite.
Yes, we're esteemed.
To come down to look at that.
We love being judged.
We're judging.
We do it all day. People watch.
The week of July 12th, the winners will be selected. And then July 22nd to 25th, our teen film crew will be bringing all of those storyboarding contest winners' creative works to life.
Nice.
This is a great program.
Gina, we have to remind everybody, we're going to see somebody from WQED on a regular basis here, right?
You are.
Yeah, I'm pretty excited.
On the podcast. All right, so let's get to
sing.
First of all, do you have a junk drawer item?
I do.
Yes.
Okay. Bring on the junk
drawer.
Because
I feel like the singing's going to be the crescendo.
This is what's in my junk drawer. A million business cards.
Oh.
This is so if we forget how to contact
this is not
mine.
Hers.
Oh.
Yeah.
No. Just so you know, if anybody here gives me a business card, you could end up in my junk drawer.
I love that. That is so great.
We might have to Google this person to see if they're still working
because
here.
I take pictures of them.
Instead of
just carrying them around. But then I feel bad throwing them away because people gave them to me.
This is hysterical. Yeah. My dad is not going to be happy with you. He is so old school. He's like, this chick doesn't even keep the business cards. He'd be putting them in like the plastic sleeves. So then
he's like, she's not getting one of mine.
Yeah. I don't throw them away. Okay. I keep
we
them.
Love,
there.
But we end up getting them, so we'll take them.
All right. So now it comes to the karaoke question.
Yeah.
So we're doing karaoke with the city paper and in next month. And then if you win, you get to go on the Berg bus with us. But what is your karaoke song?
Wow, my go-to karaoke is Joan Jett.
I love rock and roll.
Put another dime in the jukebox,
Liz
baby.
Berlin's joining
I love rock and roll. So come and take your time and dance with
me. It is your Jagoff late night. We have more strawberry jello pretzel salad next.
I've been thinking that Rohrich Automotive needs a new jingle.
Rohrich Automotive got the best cars around Pittsburgh.
Driving a Rohrich, I bought it at Rohrich. Picked up my new car at Rohrich Automotive.
I got friends at Rohrich Automotive where the staff is nice and the dealership's loaded with brand new cars. And you can drive real far.
Mancini's Bakery, 97 years in business and still getting better. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Instagram. That's where you will see various Pittsburgh personalities like Gretchen McKay, Super Bowl MVP Santonio Holmes, KDKA's own Mary Hours, and WPXI's Jenna Harner, learning how to make the famous Italian twist bread. Follow Mancini Bakery on Instagram and Facebook, and remember to ask for Mancini's.
On a Rachel, you jag off late night, and we're still talking strawberry jello pretzel salad. Now, the event may be over by the time you're listening or watching this, but the fact is strawberry jello pretzel salad is still a staple every summer here in Pittsburgh. And with us is Augusta from Kemi's Kitchen. How are you?
Good, thank you.
So we've spent a little bit of a day today together because we were down on TV. And Cameron, listen, if you're listening to it on the radio, go to our Facebook page or YouTube channel, watch, because Chef Cameron is going to steal the show tonight here. So first of all, welcome back to the podcast.
Thank you.
You were on the radio with us, I think, at one point, but never really, I can't remember. Then Rachel decided to do some cake pops.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So first of all, tell us a little bit about Kemi's Kitchen before we get into the salad.
We're a catering company, so we do a lot of catering, and we will be opening up a takeout spot on Brownsville Road in August.
Nice.
Okay.
Well, I can attest that your desserts, people say it all over social media, but I've actually had them, purchased them. Phenomenal. I mean, and not just in taste, but you are just so detail driven on your colors, and it's just amazing. Where did that start?
I used to work at the post office, and
I was really stressed
out, and baking was relaxing and fun, and I learned a lot on YouTube.
I never knew that about you.
Yeah.
How about that?
Yeah.
That is really cool.
Do you like to cook better or bake better? I know baking's your livelihood, but so is catering. So cooking or baking?
Right. Well, I like to eat, so.
You like both?
Yeah.
Who doesn't? Yeah, we totally get it.
Yeah.
So we asked you this when we were on Talk Pittsburgh, obviously, earlier today. You know, was there some kind of staple or some kind of recipe, or did you guys make this in your family, or no?
No. So my dad is from here, and his ex-girlfriend actually introduced it to me. And at first I was like, I don't think I want to try that. But I tried it, and it was really good. So I started making it around 2009.
Okay.
Okay.
And now it's something like, or people like, hey, Augusta, you're the person who needs to bring it.
Yeah, I do get a lot of orders.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So for people who aren't really following along, the strawberry pretzel jello salad standoff is every confectioner's, you know, sort of concoction. How do they see it? Not everybody makes it the standard way. Because, you know, we've had plenty of our viewers weigh in on how they would do it.
Mm-hmm.
So we know that we have a milkshake. We know that we have a little cheesecake bite. We know that we have cookies. What do we have with you?
So this year I decided to do a Rice Krispie treat.
Amazing.
Yes. Yeah. It's a strawberry Rice Krispie with a cream cheese glaze and then the pretzel crust.
Yeah, and wow. We tasted this earlier. We're not giving it to anybody here at the studio to taste, but
where am
no,
I
it's it is. It's like a half inch or so thick of Rice Krispie treats. Then everything's laid on top of that, and the pretzels on yours are on the top, yeah. But it's also mixed with.
Well, it's a traditional crust, the brown sugar, butter, and pretzels.
Yeah.
I just crumbled it up after I baked it.
Yeah.
Because that's how I usually do my pretzel salad upside down.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice. And, you know, you made a good point. This is your third year. You've actually done this with us. I think you might be one of the only ones who have done it with us from the beginning. You're the OG. Right. Yeah. So you know a little bit more. Jen already left, so you don't have to give her any tips on what, you know, how to make them precise or anything like that. But you're also partnering up with somebody new this year. Who is your charitable?
Yes. I chose Gwen's Girls this
yeah,
year.
Yeah, that's a great charity.
Yeah.
So if you win... $500 goes to Gwen's Girls,
right.
So that's absolutely amazing. We love the fact that you're doing this with us. We can't thank you enough. Where can everybody find you and follow you? You have a website, social media, all that good stuff?
Yes, our website is kimmyskitchen.net, and we are on Facebook at Kimmy's Kitchen and Catering with a K, and Instagram. We have Kimmy's Kitchen 412, and then me, Miss Kimmy's Kitchen 412.
Cake sure. Pops.
And listen, I'm going to shout pops. You out because it is graduation season. I'm sure you get busy, but I have utilized your amazing efforts, and it is graduation time. Get those orders in because they're phenomenal.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We wish you the best of luck. We loved it. What? Go ahead.
No, junk drawer item. Oh, please, okay. It's not Cam.
Oh, Cam. No. Yeah. I will take Cam.
I have to take him home.
You are the cutest thing I've ever seen.
So for anybody listening and you think you hear a baby in the background, it
you
is
do.
Indeed. Yes, Chef Cameron. Oh, and you're pulling out.
This is a one of those nausea bands.
Oh.
When I was pregnant with him last year, he gave me vertigo. So I had the extra nub on my other, on my watch, and then I just had them both on. It just helped with the motion sickness.
Okay.
And
they really do help. That is such a clever
How about that?
I love that. Okay,
Cam likes perfect. It now, too. We're not even right. getting it. All right, karaoke song. You have a favorite karaoke? What are you singing when you're baking,
what's your go-to?
When you're cooking?
Yeah.
Well, I listen to a little bit of different things, but the song that I sing the most now because of him is the Spice Girls. Tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
That is such a good song. That's my apology. That was a great one. And he loves it?
Mm-hmm.
Of course he does.
Well, let's see. So one more time, the website?
Kimmyskitchen.net.
Right. So take us out. I'll say Kimmyskitchen.net. And our music bed is Tell Me What You...
So...
Tell me what you want, what you really, really want. Tell me what you want, what I really, really
Next,
want.
Next, we're going to have a real singer, Liz Berlin.
I would say probably the softest side of me is my mother, very empathetic, you know. No one to mess with, though, but she was very empathetic.
It's Rachel and John.
We are at the Operations Center of People's Gas for this episode of People.
Behind People's.
I feel like we're taking over. You're seeing more women in manager positions and supervisors, and they know what they're doing.
Women with Energy is a great ERG. We do not play. We are very energetic. We get the job done.
If my younger self could see me doing these things now, I wouldn't believe it. To be a steam fitter, you need to be a problem solver. You can do instrumentation, hydronics, chillers, rigging, HVAC. I have this wonderful opportunity to grow my career.
It's not what you are that makes you a steam fitter, it's who you are. Over 100 years, and we're just getting started.
Mancini's Bakery, 97 years in business and still getting better. Make sure you follow us on Facebook and Instagram. That's where you will see various Pittsburgh personalities like Gretchen McKay, Super Bowl MVP Santonio Holmes, KDKA's own Mary Hours, and WPXI's Jenna Harner, learning how to make the famous Italian twist bread. Follow Mancini Bakery on Instagram and Facebook, and remember to ask for Mancini's.
You jag off late night, and it's John and Rachel, and we have had this person on our podcast before, And we've been to her place. And, right. And Rachel, just tell the story about our next guest naming her first.
I won't. If you follow me, you know that I'm obsessed because I loved Rusted Root. I followed in during my college days. We actually got to go to Mr. Small's, which we're going to talk about tonight. So it's the one and only Liz Berlin.
Liz Berlin,
welcome back. Hello. We love when we find out you're our music guest. It brings us so much joy. The real beauty is you have so many things that you're involved in. We have to go through a slew of dates. You're worse than us. We have to put dates on the screen because you have so much going on.
I have a whole list here, honestly.
This is amazing. So the point is you're doing so many things. You and your husband are the co-owners of Mr. Small's.
Mm-hmm, yep.
It's an amazing venue where people want to be all the time. So many different artists have been through.
Thanks.
And you start with April 25th. What do we have going on?
April 25th is the We Rock Academy album drop celebration. I run a program called the We Rock Workshop that is free songwriting, production, and recording opportunities for current and former foster youth or any youth with a history of CYF, and from the ages of 14 to 24. So it's transition age youth programming. And this event on the 25th is our dedicated students that are participating in the We Rock Academy. They're going to be releasing a whole album of 12 songs, completely written and recorded throughout this program, and they're going to be performing live on stage. We're going to have
And you free work dinner. With them. You're working with them through
I've been with them
they
every step of the way.
They earn a spot. Right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They earn a spot into your academy.
Yes.
Then you work them through this. And how long does the academy last?
It's a 30-week program.
Wow.
It's 6 weeks of an intro class and then 8 weeks in the studio, 8 weeks rehearsal, the show. After the show, we're taking them to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland to perform and visit the museum.
Wow.
And then after that, 6 more weeks of encore classes where we talk to them about how to become a real artist, make sure no one has your name, make sure everyone, all the money's coming to you, and what opportunities you can find outside of the We Rock Workshop program. Wow. To continue their aspirations.
All such important things. Because it's one thing to master your music craft. We've talked about this so many times. And there's so many talented people, but it's really knowing the business of the business, right?
Yeah.
That's
Liz,
fantastic.
I think it's cool that, needless to say, as part of your career, you made it to the top of the mountain, right? And then, so you did that. By the way, while you're going up the mountain, Rachel was following you around all the state colleges. So you made it to the top of the mountain. Now you decide to stay here in Pittsburgh and kind of give back, which is super cool. I mean, I'm sure you had options to go other places, but why here?
As I traveled around the country and the world, I was like, this is great. I'm going to find out what the coolest places are so I can figure out where I want to move to.
Sure.
The more I traveled, the more I just wanted to be home.
Isn't that
Pittsburgh
amazing?
Is the best place, honestly, of every place that I've ever been to. I wouldn't ever have wanted to make a life, nor could I have made the life that I currently have anywhere else in America or the world.
That's so awesome to hear, especially because you have been to so many places. And you, like us, have watched Pittsburgh really evolve, because it wasn't what it is.
Well, you, like us, are part of that evolution. It's important for us to stick around. It's important for us to give back to our communities and build things like Mr. Smalls that are just going to uplift the music community of Pittsburgh, uplift the community of Millvale. It's important.
There you go. And all right. She's on a timeline. Do you know this?
Because
she also, so I don't want to get your train of thought
off.
We
have a list of things.
May 1st. What is happening May 1st?
Because
are you doing this thing with Gina for WQED or is there something else?
May 1st. So there's an artist from Pittsburgh by the name of Ann Feeney. She is legendary folk singer, songwriter, labor organizer, activist. And she, unfortunately, we lost her during COVID. And this is the first opportunity we're having to get together and commemorate her memory. It's going to be open to the public. It's going to be a beautiful evening. They're going to actually be having a panel discussion earlier, I believe, at 12:30 at the History Museum. And then at 6 p.m., everyone's welcome to come down to Mr. Small's for a commemoration. There's going to be, I'll be performing along with Fat Mandy, another artist named Emma's Revolution, and several other friends and family and musicians from all over the country are flying in for this thing.
This is my Pittsburgh confession. I have never seen Fat Mandy in person. Never. Isn't that crazy? Yeah. I need to do this. Yeah. We need to make it down there. Okay.
It's going to be really beautiful. Anne was, honestly, she was my first musical mentor in Pittsburgh.
Oh, wow.
I first started playing the guitar at 16, and I was playing at this open stage at this lesbian bar named Bloomers on the South Side.
Oh, my God.
And my mommy and my daddy were there and went up to Anne and were like, our daughter Lizzie really wants to do music professionally. Can you talk to her?
So
Anne Feeney, she came and talked to me. Not only did she talk to me, she took me a week later to Philadelphia to the People's Music Network Conference, where I was exposed to songwriters and activists from all over the world, including Pete Seeger and lots of really big names in that scene.
Heck yeah.
And it was like the beginning of my inspiration of songwriting and activism.
And you do both very
the
well.
Mentor yeah. now, the mentee is now the mentor,
yeah.
which is really
yeah.
kind of crazy, right?
Well, I guess she inspired me in that way too then.
Yeah, yeah. Isn't that the truth? Yeah,
absolutely.
For sure.
It's so important.
And we're going to go a little bit off the timeline because we're gonna have to end with what we're doing with her. But we're doing two things with her, actually. Mm-hmm. So we had to double check the calendar. We got a text message from our friend Sarah in Millville about emceeing. May 17th starts the Millville Music Fest, which has been around. Do you know how many years it's been now?
I don't know.
Yeah, it's a ton.
That's
is what
a
I know.
Lot, but it's growing and growing and growing. It's just getting bigger
for
and bigger.
For people who don't know, so they have multiple stages in Millville. So some are outdoor, but Mr. Smalls serves as one, correct?
Mr. Smalls serves as four.
Multiple, right.
Four
right.
stages. We'll have the fun house, and in the theater, we'll have the main stage and a side stage. And we also are blocking off all of Butler Street and putting an outdoor stage at the top of the hill.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's the one you do early in the night, not after you've had a few drinks.
The roll down
the hill is going to be quick.
No, you'll be okay.
That stage goes
until about 10, I think. I'll be playing that stage on Saturday at around 5:30.
Okay.
My husband's new band, The Conspiracy Theory, which check them out, they're awesome.
Yeah,
we'll be playing in the Fun House on Friday, and my son Jordan Speranzo is helping to curate the first ever classical music stage on Friday, and that's going to take place at St. Nick's Church up on the hill.
Wow.
That's a cool thing.
Yeah.
That's
super
awesome.
Cool, right?
Well, and we have to tell Sarah that we were just conspiring that we're not sure where we're emceeing, so we may have to put in for Mr. Smalls.
Yes.
We're just not sure.
Right. I would love that.
It would be fantastic. Mm-hmm. I mean, and we love the fact, anytime that there is music, and outdoors especially, it just signifies that summer is coming.
Yeah.
And we have so much talent in this
Yay,
city.
Summer.
I'm so excited for summer. Right, same. We cannot agree more. Now we can go back in time, because on May 15th, we are actually talking all about this karaoke cabaret that's happening at your place. So it's so funny. We were talking to the city paper folks today, and we said, oh, look, they have it right there. So May 15th, 7 to 10, Mr. Smalls. It's all ages. It's $20. We're super stoked for it because prizes range from $250 to $1,000. And apparently we have like 30 people signed up already. So we want to get more and more singers who are not nervous, right?
Right. Oh, and the big thing is that some of it is a audience applause. So if you're singing, you need to bring all of your buds.
It's only 20 bucks.
What a night can you
As
have?
As I'm emceeing, I'm going to be like, it's my turn. And I'm going to be like, all right, audience. I'm giving it a shot because I think it's such a cool opportunity for people to, first of all, witness Mr. Smalls because it's an amazing place. So many of the musicians who we have on this show talk about Mr. Smalls being their favorite place to perform. It's great. Yeah. It's a testament to what you've built. Yeah. But also, I think it's an opportunity for like an open mic, you know, to just kind of have fun and feel free to just make mistakes.
It's a cool day for a night out as well because there's so many places to go have a coffee, something to eat,
maybe
before,
great.
After, and just roam around Millville. So, and then come to the sing karaoke, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's going to be so much fun.
We get to see a lot of you in May, so sorry, you cannot shake us this
You're
time.
My best friend.
We love it. Well, we're really excited because we actually get to hear you perform, which we've not done in quite some time. So did you bring us a junk drawer gift that I get to oddly fangirl and say, look what I got.
I have a million of these in all of my drinks. And this one's very well used. You can see.
Oh, wait. Okay. John. Okay.
Here you go. Oh, yeah, I see it. All
Did
right.
you notice she was, like, winking? She's like, Rachel, I've used that.
Yeah.
I'll text my college roommate. Like, Dad, I'll text Tabby. I just talked to Liz again, and I got a guitar pick. So.
This is
awesome. I mean, we truly love, you know, I'm not kidding. You're phenomenal at what you do, but we love what you're doing for this city. And it keeps Pittsburgh on the map for our musical talent.
Thank you.
Yeah,
that means
absolutely.
A lot.
Yeah, I think it keeps kids here. you know, who want to be musicians, knowing mm-hmm. that they can live here and do yeah. their thing.
Well, it means a lot to us to be doing it. So thank you for helping yeah. to
absolutely
amplify.
We need to have your husband's band come on and do,
yeah.
Yes. Something yeah.
They would
yeah.
love it.
We'll have to, Tracy, we're on that.
Yeah.
That's
now,
your cue.
Now, you are going to sing for us. So let's yes. talk about the song that you're going to sing, because there's no sense in having you do karaoke, but
oh.
right now.
She wanted to
oh,
I wanted to tell you about.
All right.
So I sang karaoke last night at Mr. Small's Cafe. We're starting to do some evening programming.
Okay.
And last night was karaoke.
What
we
did
were
you do?
Partying until 11 p.m. I sang Rock of Ages by Def Leppard.
Oh, God.
Oh my God.
And I sang Kissed by a Rose by Seal. And I sang Open Arms by Journey.
Oh my well, God. Journey's like well, always.
All right. So the bottom line is you're going
to
sing a song later. But as we yeah. go to break, take us, get everybody singing a karaoke song with you then.
Yeah.
Do
yeah,
that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Let's
yeah.
do
what
it.
What song are you
what's
doing? Because you know
what's
I'm singing
be?
It with you.
Oh, for that?
Yeah.
For them?
You got to do
oh,
it.
Oh God. We'll have to talk about what we're going to
okay.
do.
Okay. All right. So we will join yes. on stage. How's
but
that?
I don't want to win.
Go.
I don't want to win anything.
Something. I don't want to win either.
Something to look forward to on May 15th is that a duet between Liz Berlin and the first person she's fangirled forever,
Rachel
Renebeck.
Dreams are coming yeah. true at the karaoke cabaret. Yeah.
Rachel's
there you
dreams.
Go. All right. So we're yeah. super stoked. Liz, yeah. where does everybody find you and follow you?
LizBerlin.com has links to everything. There's also a Linktree/LizBerlin, which I put current links to all kinds of things up there.
Yeah, all the dates we talked about will
yeah.
be there.
Yeah.
We're going to take a quick break and let you get set up, and
all
we're
right.
back late.
Okay.
It's your Jagoff Late Night.
PittsburghUsedCars.com. With hundreds of used cars across 8 dealerships throughout the city, we provide the greater Pittsburgh area with a premium used car buying experience. Looking for unbeatable pricing on some of the best used cars in Pittsburgh? Visit Pittsburgh Used Cars Clearance Zone today. We're providing out-the-door pricing on all of our clearance zone inventory. PittsburghUsedCars.com.
People used to celebrate hard work, the spirit of the underdog. You don't hear too much about those things anymore. The world needs more problem solvers. People who know results matter. Folks with brains and elbow grease. Our work runs through just about every office building in the city like a network of veins. It's not what you are that makes you a steam fitter. It's who you are.
I'm Liz Berlin. I'm honored to be here on YaJagoff podcast. I'm going to sing a song for you that was written by one of my We Rock Academy students named Bradford. He's going to be performing this at Mr. Small's Theater on April 25th for their big concert. So come see it. It's free. Thank you.
Rates, jump in there.
I found it. Ready? Can
Do
you
it.
Cut the parts together?
We got you.
The beautiful way that you love me. I've come so far from doubt and fear. Protector, provider, your father. My light, my love, I will always be near. Shatter pieces of my life. I've finally been made right. So this is love.
Harmonizing in
the
back.
Oh my God, Liz Berlin.
Liz Berlin,
that was fantastic.
Thank you so much. April 25th.
Thank you, obviously, to everybody who came on. Thank you so much to specifically Rohrich Automotive for bringing us YaJagoff Late Night. Thanks to our new friends, Lucky Sign Spirits. We need to have them back so that we can really enjoy all those great distilled drinks. Go ahead.
Yeah.
And our Strawberry Pretzel Jell-O Salad folks, Kemi's Kitchen, and Isley's, and to the one and only WQED. Thanks for joining us on YaJagoff Late Night.